You can add a regression line to any one of these traces on the pie trend. Now this trend, same one I did before, it looks a little different because I increased the line weight on the pen colors there, but just to make it easier to see. So let me show you an example. This tag right here, CDT158, that's the blue tag right here, the blue trace. I'd like to do a regression line on that blue trace. And what you're seeing here, this regression line, let me go ahead and highlight this. Yeah, there we go. That regression line is showing me the first of all, the value at which I was just touching the regression line. So the value right here is 142. Now watch, that's going to change as I, if I move this somewhere else. See, now it's 145, now it's 153. So the value line, that first line that you see is the line on the linear regression. The second thing you're going to see here is you're going to see this M. That's the slope. So in this case, the slope is fairly slight here. The third item, this t-int. T-int stands for time intercept. And the intercept they're talking about is where this regression line will intersect or intercept the y-axis. So if you look at this, we're looking at, what is this? This is from the 25th, an 8-hour trend starting 2:40 a.m. on the 25th. Look at the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the 23rd. And that makes sense because as you can look at this regression, you know, going backward in time, it's going to be about at the 23rd where this intersects the y-axis. And then finally, we see this r. R stands for the coefficient of correlation, or the r coefficient. So if you're familiar with XY plots or scatter plots, that's what we're talking about there. Now let's compare that. That R coefficient indicates a fairly weak correlation, and it's a correlation between time and value here. So on the x-axis we have time, of course, on the y-axis is the value. So compare that to, let's look at our sine wave. As you can see, each one of these can have its own regression line. I'll go ahead and add a regression line for sine wave. And this regression line, it has a much stronger slope. It's a the slope here is this negative 3.7 to the third. The coefficient of correlation is an inverse correlation. See this, this is going negative 0.9, very strong inverse correlation, because as time goes forward, that value decreases. And the time intercept is, it actually may be within the trend itself, but we're seeing the t-intercept, yeah, right there. So that's how you interpret this, and this is available again for each individual trace using this regression line option.